Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the 2017 Distinguished Achievement Program Graduate Banquet. I'm Aaron Lozano, and I'll be your Master of Ceremonies. We'll begin first with the PSJ Memorial Early College High School JROTC, the Mighty Wolverine Battalion Color Guard, led by right guard Cadet Sergeant Olivia Cervantes, carrying the United States flag is Cadet Command Sergeant Major Carolina Ramirez, carrying the Texas flag is Cadet Sergeant Kaylee Russell, and left guard Cadet Sergeant Ruben Villanueva. Leading the Pledge of Allegiance today is our Student Council Representative, Brianna Eileen Liao.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic in which it stands, and one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you, Ms. Leal. Leading the Texas Pledge today, ladies and gentlemen, our Senior Class President, Karina Salinas.
Honor the Texas flag. I pledge allegiance to thee, Texas, one state, under God, one and indivisible.
Thank you, Karina. Next, we have our national anthem, sung by Memorial Early College High School choir member, Luis Alberto Rivera.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the rampart we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's red glare, the bomb bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the brave?
Thank you, Mr. Rivera. And now, our invocation to be led by our Wolverine Band Head Drum Major, Mr. Orlando Ochoa.
At this time, please bow your heads. Heavenly Father, as we assemble here tonight in celebration of our academic achievements, let us begin by expressing our sincerest appreciation for your guidance and wisdom that led each and every one of us here. We come to you today in gratitude for your ever-present beacon of love and support. We will always be indebted to our administration, faculty, and staff for constant encouragement, our friends for the lifelong bonds that have been created, and our families for the continuous love that inspired us to keep moving forward if ever we found ourselves defeated. We thank you for blessing us with the opportunity to learn and grow both as students and young adults. May we always remember the path that you blazed before us, as well as the one we will continue conquering. As we embark onto the next chapter of our lives, we ask that you continue protecting and guiding us on our individual journeys towards greater goals and accomplishments. We ask this in the name of Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Post colors. Ladies and gentlemen, the PSJ Memorial Early College High School, JROTC. At this time, I'd like to introduce our PSJ Memorial Early College High School principal, Mr. Juan C. Garza. Everyone may sit.
Thank you, Mr. Lozano. Good evening, parents, guardians, family members, educators, board members, and most importantly, PSJ Memorial's Early College High School Distinguished Achievement Program graduates. It is my honor to welcome you all on behalf of our administration team and the Wolverine family to our annual DAP banquet. It's with great pride that I stand here before you and your families to recognize your outstanding achievements. With determination and focus, you have invested the last 4 years of your lives to secure the scholastic rewards that have been established for you. You have earned these distinguished incentives through dedicated behaviors such as organization and days and nights of unfaltering studying and preparation. As a result, you can look around the room and see your fellow students who are no longer just prospective high school graduates, but also college students who have completed graduation requirements at STC and will participate in a college commencement ceremony prior to graduating from high school. 45 of the students here today before us have completed or will be completing their associate's degree, and others have completed college certificates prior to graduating from high school. Will these 45 students that will graduate with an associate's degree please stand to be recognized? You can be seated. We also have, and I would like to recognize, six students who have been part of a first in the nation nursing program and will be graduating from high school and become registered nurses prior to graduating from high school. Will these six students please stand to be recognized? Thank you, students, and great job. Students, we are proud to see that you're leaving a legacy at PSJ Memorial and challenging the rest of the student body to step up to the academic success and continue the academic growth that will someday mark our community with much better leadership and skills and will improve the life in the PSJ area as we know it today. Today, it's about your success, your accomplishments, your destinies, and without a doubt, all of y'all will continue your college studies and pursue bachelor's, master's, and doctorate degrees. This banquet and ceremony is just a small token of appreciation in honor for all your hard work and dedication that you have contributed to your education. In a class of 435 students, there are 114 of you who challenge yourselves to stay the course and graduate DAP. Once again, congratulations. On behalf of myself, the PSJ Memorial Early College administration and staff, I want to congratulate you, welcome you, and thank you for this time this evening. Thank you.
At this time, I'd like to welcome the PSJ ISD Superintendent of Schools, Dr. Daniel P. King.
Thank you very much. Let me begin by introducing a team of individuals who provide tremendous leadership, vision, and support for all of the educational programs that we have here in PSJ, extracurricular programs as well, and who, you know, most of us here, teachers, administrators, counselors, we do this as our profession, but these individuals do it for no pay, and they do it just because they want to invest back, and they all happen to be graduates of this school district. So I'd like to introduce to you our board members that are present here tonight. So we have our board vice president, Mr. Jesse Zambrano. We have our board secretary treasurer, Mr. Jesse Vela. We have our assistant secretary treasurer, Mr. Jorge Zambrano. And we have board member, Mr. Victor Perez. And I want to thank them and our other board members, like I said, because they're the ones who set the policies, adopt the budget, and really give a lot of the inspiration for the work that we do here in the district. At this time, I would just want to take a few minutes, students, first of all, to congratulate you. I want to thank you for all the effort that you've put in over the last 4 years of high school, and really over the 13 years or so that you have invested in your educational pathway so far. And I say so far because I just heard your principal talk about how you're going to keep on going, and we're going to look forward to hearing about that as you get your, earn your bachelor's degrees and master's degrees and on up and beyond. But I want to thank you for what you've done during these years in high school. And each of you here tonight has taken on the challenge and really taken advantage of the opportunities presented to you by your faculty there at the high school, by our college partners, and by others around. And you have chosen to go above and beyond, not to just do the minimum, not just to attend, not just to earn a high school diploma, but to go beyond and to take on the challenging DAP measures, the Distinguished Achievement Measures, to take college courses. It's good to see that so many of you have already reached some status of college completion, completing associate degrees, certificates. Certainly proud, you know, another kind of first for PSJ having, and it looks to me like this high school has the largest cohort. That's those six students who are completing their nursing degree here while they're in high school. Tremendous accomplishments. And then pretty much most, if not all of you here, have already started your college work. So I want to congratulate you on that and just urge you to take advantage of that head start you've gotten and make sure that you go on to complete. Set your goals high and go on to complete those. Involve yourself, just like you did in high school, in college. Don't just go to college and do the minimum. Don't just show up. Don't just look at your degree plan and meet the requirements of that. But get involved in college life, get involved in the different organizations, get involved in giving back like you have here in high school. Get involved in all of those things, and you will be the better for it, and so will everyone around you. Parents, I want to thank you for all the work that you've done. You've obviously done a great job looking at these fine young men and women and the work they've done up to this point. I want to thank you for choosing PSJA to be your educational partner to bring these young people to this point in their educational career. I want to thank you for working hand in hand with us to prepare them for the next step. And I want to assure you that just like you, we will still be here for them. I know that you will be there for your children as they go on into adulthood and as they go through college. And I wanted to let you know that PSJ is very unique in that we don't just say that we're still going to be here for them, we mean it. Any situations that you face in your children's college work, whether it's the application process, whether it's financial aid, whether it's this year, next year, the following year, whether it's getting into graduate school, getting into law school, whatever it is that you need, we're here for you. So you can come back to your high school for help, but we also have a special department to help your children as they go on. So just as you're there by their side, we want you to know that PSJ is right here to continue working with you hand in hand. So I want to introduce to you some special people that you may not have met yet, but they can play a very important role over the next few years with your young people. So at PSJ, we have what we call a college transition department, and these are some special counselors that work with their higher education partners to make sure that our graduates get into the seats in college, that they get all their issues taken care of, and if they're having any struggles or challenges in college or in the university, that they have somebody from home besides their parents, but somebody from their home school district to turn to. So first of all, I want to introduce you to you, Ms. Vera Boda. If she'll please stand. Ms. Boda is the head of our college transition department. How many of you are thinking that you may go away to college, that you may leave the valley for your university? Okay, Ms. Boda's job, besides overseeing the department, she works to support you if you're going away. On your table in front of you, you'll see this card. So if you take a look at it, her name is on there, and there is her email address, there's her phone number, and everything else so that you can contact her for help. If you're next, I want to introduce to you Mr. Carlos Garcia. And Mr. Garcia is assigned to South Texas College. And so any of you, if you're going to continue your education at South Texas College, Mr. Carlos Garcia actually has an office at South Texas College as well as here in the district. So you can find him there or on this card. Again, is his phone number, email address. So if you have any questions, need any help there. And then last but not least, we have Mr. Alonso Garcia. Mr. Alonso Garcia? Mr. Alonso Garcia has an office at UTRGV in Edinburgh. So if you're going there, he can help you again. And so we know they have a lot of students just like we do, but that somebody at home, that from home, that can help you with any issues that you have there. Thank you, Mr. Garcia. Padres de familia, quiero darles las gracias por todo el apoyo que nos han dado por escogiendo el sistema escolar de Falso Juan Álamo para educar a sus hijos mano a mano con ustedes. Quiero darles las gracias por trabajando juntamente con nosotros. Y les quiero decir que estamos muy orgullosos de sus hijos, de todo el éxito que han tenido durante su carrera educativa. Y para decirles que el parte de nosotros, igual como el parte de ustedes, el parte de ustedes no se va a acabar cuando ellos reciben su diploma. La responsabilidad de padre sigue, ¿verdad? Pero nosotros también seguimos. Vamos a seguir, aquí estamos para seguir con ustedes mano en mano, apoyando a sus hijos. Si ellos necesitan ayuda, consejos, si están batallando con todas las formas del colegio, con ayuda financiera, con haciendo decisiones, nosotros tenemos un departamento especial para ayudar a nuestros graduantes. Y en esta tarjeta en su mesa, ahí están los nombres y el número de telefónico y información del correo electrónico también, donde usted puede ponerse en contacto con ellos, o también puede hablar a PSJ Memorial High School y pedir ayuda. Aquí estamos para ayudarles para hoy, pero también para el año que entra y los años que siguen. I want to thank you very much. I also want to introduce an additional board member, Mr. Ronnie Cantu, who has joined us. Mr. Garza, I want to thank you and your team for a great job. Students, again, thank you very much, and keep it going. Thank you.
At this point, I'd like to introduce Mr. Jesse Zambrano, our school board vice president.
Hello, everyone. I really was not ready to speak. I thought Mr. Vela was going to be next, but I do have a few words for all of you. Number one, congratulations to the parents, a todos los padres de familia. Les quiero felicitar a ustedes y a sus hijos por el buen trabajo que han hecho. This is the, as we like to call it, the cream of the crop of the students at PSJA Memorial. And all of you should be very proud of your accomplishments. When I look back, I graduated from high school 19 years ago, and really in the blink of an eye, you know, life just kind of happens in front of you. And so really my message to you tonight is very short. Enjoy it. Enjoy the next few weeks. Enjoy the free dinners, the free lunches that you can get, because really, after graduation, life really begins for all of you. And I hate to break it to you, but it doesn't get easier after you graduate from high school. It actually gets a little harder. Hard work and determination is going to get you a long way. But I don't have to talk to you, anybody in this room, about hard work, because the reason you're here tonight, it's because you've been doing that for the last 4 years. I will close by basically just naming a few things that should keep you grounded. And those things are your faith, your family, and your education. If you keep those three things in mind, then I am sure that your college life and your future is going to be very, very successful. You should be very proud once again. And parents, once again, congratulations.
Thank you, Mr. Zambrano. I'd also like to welcome Dr. Patty Alvarez from Manhattan. Sorry, she is from the University of Texas Rio Grande Valley, and she is the Dean of Education. So ladies and gentlemen, Dr. Patty Alvarez, Manhattan. At this time, I'd like to introduce our keynote speaker. Mr. Eric Guajardo is a proud alumnus of PSJA Memorial Early College High School. He is proud to be a Wolverine. He is the son of Jaime and Romelia Guajardo of San Juan. Eric worked hard academically throughout high school despite migrant obstacles that presented themselves. Being a migrant never limited him from being extremely involved in extracurricular activities or enrolling in dual enrollment courses. The class of 2012 valedictorian earned over 70 college credit hours while still enrolled in high school, was recognized as an AP scholar, a National Hispanic Scholar, and was featured as KRGV Channel 5's Student of the Week. He was a distinguished student who competed with 538 seniors to be number one in his senior class. After graduation, he relocated to Cambridge, Massachusetts, where he began a new chapter in his life at Harvard University. Eric earned a Bachelor of Arts from Harvard University, where he majored in economics and minored in psychology. He continued to be a very active student while attending the university as a member of the Sigma Alpha Epsilon fraternity and participating in numerous internships that helped him gain valuable work experience. He interned at the Small Business Administration and Harvard Student Agencies. The internships called for Eric to consult, translate, facilitate, and execute his business education while gaining new career experiences. He had the opportunity to work as a manager at Harvard Student Agencies, the world's largest student-run corporation, a multi-million dollar nonprofit student-run company that provides Harvard students with meaningful opportunities for employment and hands-on business education. Currently, Eric resides in Houston, where he is an analyst for Heidrick and Struggles, one of the world's top executive search firms, regularly placing executives into the C-suite and board level of Fortune 500 companies. He is also a member of the firm's Associate Development Program, a two-year rotational program designed to develop search execution skills and business acumen. Ladies and gentlemen, our keynote speaker tonight is a proud Wolverine and graduate of the class of 2012, Mr. Eric Guajardo.
Hello, everybody. Wow, what an introduction. It is good to be back. So it's only been about 5 years since I was sitting in your seats, a graduate of the PSJ Memorial Class of 2012, staring wide-eyed into the future with no idea what was in store for me. So I think I have some unique insights into what you're about to go through. So I'd like to give you all some tips as you start this next step on your life's journey. I'd also like to talk a little bit about my experiences as a proud PSJ Memorial and Harvard alumni. But before I do that, please give me the opportunity to extend my gratitude to my mother and my father sitting right over there. I want to thank them for the thousands of decisions they made that have led to this moment. I want to thank them for always keeping me motivated when I had loads of studying to do. But above all, I want to thank them for always putting my education as their number one priority. I remember when I was applying to the elite private schools, the vast majority of them charge application fees. Ms. Boda, remember, she's nodding over there. I remember feeling really, really stressed out and walking up to my mom and saying, "Ama, I can only apply to 4 colleges for free. The rest cost $75 each. Gaggle, what do I do?" And my mom tells me, "Tú aplica a todos los colegios que quieras. Apply to all the colleges you want to." And she hands me her credit card. She hands it to me. I had to beg my mom for $20 to go to the movies on the weekends. And here she was handing me her credit card. So thank you, Mom, for giving me everything I needed to achieve my dream. I'd also like to take some time to thank my dad. Growing up, my dad was always away working for the money it took to run our household. He has the best work ethic out of anyone I have ever met, including people I met at Harvard. My dad literally worked himself into a disability for us. He had a stroke at around the time I graduated from high school. And he continues to have a great work ethic. He goes to the gym more than I do. My mother and my father were truly an all-star team. I'd like to think I inherited my mom's persistence and my dad's work ethic. besides my dad's hair. Muchas gracias por todo. Les agradezco todo lo que han hecho por mí, mamá y papá. I'd like to take a short time to thank some of the teachers and counselors that helped me along as well. I want to thank Mrs. Cadena for the great migrant program. That she heads, which helped me out countless of times throughout my time in high school. I also want to thank Mrs. Boda. I want to thank her for always believing in me, for believing that a kid like me could get into Harvard. So thank you for that. And I want to thank Mr. and Mrs. Gomez for the great drama program that they led while I was here, where I have so many great memories and made so many great friends. And a special thanks to all the other educators and counselors along the way that helped me reach my dream. Thank you all. So I guess I can begin by talking a little bit about what I do. I work in Houston as an analyst with a firm called Heidrick & Struggles. It's hard to pronounce, and it's even harder to understand what we do, so let me give it a quick try. When big companies are looking to fill open positions for jobs that pay lots and lots of money, they can't just post a job opening and have people send resumes in and all that good stuff. So they hire people like my company and people like me to find them and present those qualified people. So my company, we're paid to find those qualified people. My job involves needing specialized business knowledge, and it involves talking to very, very talented people every day. It's hard work, but it's very rewarding, and I'm learning a lot. It is also filled with great people who are very understanding about work-life balance. For example, they were very understanding when I asked for a couple of days to come to speak here. So now that I've talked about what I do, let me rewind back to my high school days, about 5 years ago. So around the time I began getting accepted to pretty good colleges, I began to have some anxieties, some doubts as to why Harvard would want to accept someone like me. I had always been pretty confident in my intelligence, but I didn't know if I was quite at the Harvard level of intelligence. I began thinking about affirmative action, and I began to wonder if the only reason Harvard accepted me was to reach some yearly quota of brown kids. People would tell me stuff like that sometimes, and truth be told, it kind of brought me down. But looking back at it now, I think that a lot of the people, a lot of the kids back then, especially the ones who seem mad at me for making it out, whatever that means, were likely experiencing a lot of the doubt about themselves that I was going through. As kids growing up in the Valley trying to get educated, it feels like we're fighting against something to make it to college and beyond. But let me tell you that when I was in college, I missed this place so much. I missed the palm trees and the Spanglish and the weather. There's nothing special about people who went to elite, snobby high school academies, of which there were a lot at Harvard, let me tell you, besides their parents' bank accounts, I suppose. There is a reason why a place like Harvard would look at high schoolers from the Valley like me and you all sitting here and say, yeah, I think this person could cut it here. We bring unique experiences and insights that make us even more adaptable than those people who went to those elite high school academies. The best thing about the Valley is that it makes us an outsider to everything else in the world. I'm an outsider in Mexico, and I'm an outsider in other parts of the US. Being an outsider to places like Harvard allows people from the Valley to bring new perspectives to traditionally established practices. We're a different kind of smart, and we have a lot to bring to these old institutions. For example, during my high school graduation year, we had me and the salutatorian make it to Ivy League colleges. A couple of people from PSHA North went on to prestigious schools in Boston, one to MIT, another to Harvard. I'm definitely missing some people who went on to great colleges and did great things. But my point is, we took the same AP and college level classes you all took. I learned how to structure a college level essay. and I learned all about U.S. history here. I went to UIL tournaments in the weekend back in my Austin middle school days and in high school as well. I acted in school plays, and I was in a ton of clubs that are still around. I was always confused as to whether it was A day or B day. I'm not sure if you also do that. We still do that. So my point is, I have a ton of memories inside the halls of PSJ Memorial. I sat in the same chairs, maybe literally, you all sat 5 years ago. And here I am speaking to you all as a Harvard graduate. There's nothing special about me besides the fact that I was able to adapt to a new environment. And we're already masters at adapting. And I am sure that in 4 or 5 years, you all will have different stories about adapting to different challenges and graduating from great colleges. And now, switching gears a little bit, I'd like to talk about my college experiences. I've never really talked in detail to anyone about how my college experience went. If I had to explain it in a short way, it would be that it was hard. Probably the hardest thing I've ever done. But when I got my degree, that piece of paper that said everything I had been doing for those past 4 years was worth something, that was really something. But that was when I thought, that's when I was done with everything. When I was a freshman in college, I thought it was gonna be a piece of cake, papitas, you know? I remember thinking to myself, I'm gonna get all A's at Harvard. While that didn't exactly end up happening, I met so many brilliant and friendly people, friendships that last to this day. The buildings looked old and wonderful, like straight out of the Harry Potter movie. I started joining clubs, and I even got to see snow for the first time. It was really a dream come true. It really was a dream come true until exam season started rolling around. So when you join college, there's no one that's gonna check up on you weekly to make sure you're keeping up with your classes. You aren't gonna have weekly quizzes or anything usually. So that's why I'm so excited to see the early college initiative that we have in PSJA. I believe that because of what you all learned in high school, you all will be better equipped than I was, and you will hit the ground running. During my first exams, I had no idea how to live like a college student. I mean, I had never really lived by myself, so I didn't even know how to cook food for myself or do laundry, much less how to set my own schedule and make time for everything you need to make time for. I will admit I failed an exam because I overslept and didn't set my alarm. I didn't fail any classes, but I definitely failed some tests. And there really is no shame in that. Failure is human, failure is healthy. Failure is what tells us that what we're doing is wrong. So freshman year was a little rough academically, but nothing that wasn't fixable. And after it was over, I took some time to reflect and think about what I could improve on going forward. After my first two semesters, I realized that when I was in class, I was always nervous when speaking in front of people. So I began to focus on getting better at that. I started to try and take classes where it was a requirement to speak in front of people. I think that was one of the things that helped me succeed in college. Not necessarily that specific public speaking thing, but the fact that I would look back and reflect on the things I did and how I could keep improving. I would encourage you all to do something similar. My sophomore year of college was better academically, but not easy by any means. I decided at this time to major in economics and began to take much harder classes than what I had taken before. And the classes weren't only harder, they were much different than what I was used to. While I tended to like classes with lots of reading and writing, these classes were more numbers focused. My study schedule became more demanding on me, and studying started to feel like a full-time job. And then after my first semester, I had a realization I had been studying all wrong, at least for myself. While I usually like to memorize a bunch of stuff throughout the year and then study before the exam, I found that how I really learned best was by trial and error, by trying to solve a problem by myself and then figuring out where I went wrong. So one piece of advice I would also give you all is figure out what kind of learner you are before the end of your sophomore year of college. My junior year of college finally felt like I was getting the hang of things. I began to take the hardest classes I took, and I was starting to look at the types of jobs that I was interested in. I decided I wanted to pursue something in business and started looking into careers in the business world that I'd be interested in. During this year, I was active in my college fraternity, had an internship during the winter in Mexico, and during the summer in Washington, D.C., and I started getting the best grades I had gotten yet. My senior year of college felt like a piece of cake compared to everything. I finally got to that point. The hardest classes I had taken were behind me, and I had learned great study habits. However, I think something else I started doing very late in my academic career began to help me out as well. I began to ask the people grading my exams and essays for detailed feedback. I visited professors' offices while they were holding open office hours just to chat about stuff I found interesting in one of the lectures. During these talks with professors, they got to know me as a person, and I made great relationships with these incredible people. And I can actually thank the fact that I have the job right now thanks to one of those relationships. One final tip I have for you all is to never compare yourself to anybody. I remember in high school, some things in classes would come easier to me than to my friends. I'd make my friends angry with some of my scores sometimes. But at Harvard, I had tons of classmates who would do the same thing with me. They would say some things in class that would make me think, oh my God, I have no idea what this person is talking about. Am I even in the right class? But it really makes no sense to compare yourself to people whose story you don't know. And sometimes I would do even better on exams than those people who would make me feel dumb. There's really no big secret as to why or how I would do that. I would just study harder than them. I like to think that your success is your intelligence multiplied by your hard work. And no one in this room is stupid. You can't have zero intelligence, but you can have zero work ethic. So work hard, study hard, and success will come eventually. Might not come immediately, but it will come eventually. So thank you all again for giving me the honor of letting me share some of my insights. And to everyone sitting here, let me extend an invitation to connect with me as well. College will be hard, it's a fact. Please feel free to email me, add me on LinkedIn, shoot at me on Facebook, and let me know if there are any questions or anything I can ever help with. This is especially true for my cousins sitting here in this room, Karina and Lupita. Again, it will be hard, but we should look to do things because they are hard. There is no better teacher than failure. That is how we grow and become better people. When things get rough, always remember the people that are rooting for you. Your teachers sitting here, your counselors, your friends, your parents, and your family. United, together, si se puede. You can do it. We can do it. Thank you.
We will begin with our first step graduate, Mr. Thomas George Adams III. Is the son of Edelia Rangel. He is graduating with a total of 36 college hours, a dual language graduate, an early college high school graduate, and a Texas scholar. He plans on attending South Texas College, where he will major in computer science and minor in criminal justice. Aliyah Elva Alanis is a daughter of Christina Alanis and Joe Alanis. She is graduating with 60 college hours, received an associate's in interdisciplinary studies, is an National Honor Society member, a Texas scholar, and an early college high school graduate. Aliyah plans on attending the University of Texas at Austin and major in psychology. Paloma Alvarado is the daughter of Perla Andrea Leja and Luis Gerardo Alvarado. Paloma is earning a total of 61 college hours and a college certificate in communications and substitute certification. She is also receiving an associate's in interdisciplinary studies and is an early college high school graduate and a Texas scholar. She plans on attending Texas A&M Kingsville University, major in mathematics, and minor in physics. Joanna Mavie Aranda is a daughter of Joanna Aranda and Javier Saldana. She has earned 45 hours of college credit and has received an associate's in interdisciplinary studies. She is a Texas scholar and an early college high school graduate. She plans on attending the University of Texas Rio Grande Valley, major in criminal justice and minor in biology. Oralia Lisette Arispe is a daughter of Delia Margarita Guajardo and has earned 55 college credit hours. She is a National Honor Society member, a Texas scholar, and an early college high school graduate. She plans on attending the University of Texas Rio Grande Valley, major in exercise science, and minor in kinesiology. Dominique Arredondo is a daughter of Martin Guadalupe Arredondo and Maria Arredondo. She has earned 47 college hours, a college certificate in multimedia, and is a member of our early college high school. She is a Texas scholar and plans on attending the University of Texas Rio Grande Valley, where she will major in criminal justice and minor in psychology. Juan Carlos Benavides Jr. is the son of Juan Carlos Benavides and Maria Benavides. He has earned a total of 18 college credit hours, is a dual language graduate, a Texas scholar, and an early college high school graduate. He plans on attending South Texas College and major in business administration and a minor in music education. Samantha Marie Camara is a daughter of Norma Linda Camara and Ivan Camara. Samantha has earned 60 hours of college credit, an associate's in interdisciplinary studies. She is a National Honor Society member, a Tech Prep scholar, a Texas scholar, and an early college high school graduate. She plans on attending Texas A&M University College Station and major in biomedical sciences. She is also the recipient of the Terry Foundation Scholarship. Alondra Cano is a daughter of Bruna Leticia Cano and Omar Cano. Alondra has earned 60 hours of college credit, an associate's in interdisciplinary studies. She is a Texas scholar and an early college high school graduate. She plans on attending the University of Texas Rio Grande Valley and major in computer science. Giselle Cantu is a daughter of Magdalena Cantu and Jose Ramon Cantu. She has earned 42 college credit hours, is a member of the National Honor Society, a Texas scholar, and an early college high school graduate. Giselle plans on attending the University of Texas Rio Grande Valley and major in biology. Gidalti Cardenas is a daughter of Jose Antonio Cardenas and Karina Cardenas. Gidalti has earned 60 hours of college credit and a certification in employability skills and substitute teacher certification. She has also earned her associates in interdisciplinary studies and graduated magna cum laude from South Texas College. She is a National Honor Society member, a dual language graduate, a Texas scholar, and an early college high school graduate. She plans on attending Dallas Baptist University and major in sociology. Cassandra Cassell Castillo is a daughter of Marianne Hernandez and Rick Castillo. She has earned 60 hours of college credit and has received an associate's degree in criminal justice. She is a Texas scholar and an early college high school graduate. She plans on attending Sam Houston State University and major in criminology and minor in business. Diamond Nicole Castillo is a daughter of George Castillo and Marty Castillo. She has earned 52 hours of college credit. She is a National Honor Society member. She is a Texas scholar and a graduate of the Early College High School. She plans on attending the University of Texas Rio Grande Valley and major in sociology and minor in criminal justice. Samantha Lee Chavez is a daughter of Veronica Lee Landa and Eric Landa. She has earned 65 hours of college credit and an associate in interdisciplinary studies. She is a member of the National Honor Society and a Texas scholar and an early college high school graduate. She plans on attending the University of Texas Rio Grande Valley and major in nursing and minor in kinesiology. Alexandra Corpus is a daughter of David Corpus and Alejandra Corpus. She has earned 60 hours of college credit and an associate's in education. She is a Texas scholar and an early college high school graduate. She plans on attending the University of Texas Rio Grande Valley and major in mathematics. Juana Maria Cruz is a daughter of Blanca Estela Cruz and Alejandro Cruz. She has earned 62 college credit hours and an associate's in interdisciplinary studies. She is a Texas scholar and an early college high school graduate. She plans on attending the University of Texas Rio Grande Valley and major in nursing. Juan Manuel Daniel Jr. is the son of Martha Griselda Daniel and Juan Manuel Daniel Sr. He has earned 15 hours of college credit and is a Tech Prep scholar and a Texas scholar. He is enlisted in the United States Marine Corps. Brandy Monique De La Rosa is a daughter of Andy De La Rosa and Femelisa De La Rosa. She has earned 28 hours of college credit. She is a Texas scholar and an early college high school graduate. Brandy plans on attending the University of Texas Rio Grande Valley and major in early childhood education and minor in kinesiology. Angie De Leon is a daughter of Maria Elda De Leon and Alonso De Leon. She has earned 27 hours of college credit, a certification as a multimedia computer specialist, and is a Tech Prep scholar. She is also a Texas scholar and an early college high school graduate. She plans on attending the University of Texas Rio Grande Valley, major in psychology and minor in education. Daniel Delgado Jr. is the son of Sonia Urbina and has earned 15 hours of college credit. He is a Tech Prep scholar and a Texas scholar. He plans on attending Texas State Technical College and major in welding technology. Melanie Ann Enriquez is a daughter of Amy D. De La Rosa and Cesar Enriquez. Melanie has earned 70 college credit hours, an associate's in sociology. She is a National Honor Society member. She is a Texas scholar and an early college high school graduate. She plans on attending the University of Texas at Austin, major in international relations and global studies, and double major, also major in sociology. Melanie is also the recipient of the Terry Foundation Scholarship. Reina Miriam Espinosa is a daughter of Miriam Espinosa and Remigio Jr. Espinosa. Reina has earned 47 hours of college credit, a certification as a substitute teacher, and an associate in education. She is a Texas scholar, an early college high school graduate, and plans on attending the University of Texas Rio Grande Valley, where she will major in history. Yashima Esquivel is a daughter of Andiel Esquivel and Maria Esquivel. She has earned 30 hours of college credit and an associate's in criminal justice. She is a Texas scholar and an early college high school graduate. She plans on attending the University of Texas Rio Grande Valley, major in psychology and minor in law. Jeremy Paul Figueroa is the son of Judith Valdez. He has earned 44 hours of college credit and is a Texas scholar. Jeremy plans on attending the university, that's Ohio State University, and major in architecture and minor in business. Stephanie Flores is a daughter of Mary Lane Mendoza and Jesus Gerardo Flores. She has earned 61 hours of college credit, an associate's in interdisciplinary studies. She is a Texas scholar and an early college high school graduate. She plans on attending Texas A&M University, major in forensic investigative science, and minor in psychology. Rolando Galvan Jr. is the son of Rolando Galvan and the daughter of Elida Galvan. He has earned 43 hours of college credit, is a Texas scholar, and an early college high school graduate. He plans on attending the University of Texas Rio Grande Valley and major in business. Marisol Gamboa is a daughter of Francisca Gamboa and Antonio Gamboa. She has earned 21 hours of college credit. She is a Texas scholar and an early college high school graduate. She plans on attending the University of Texas Rio Grande Valley, major in early childhood education and minor in early childhood. Joe Daniel Garcia is the son of Jennifer Lee Romo and Jerry James Romo. He has earned 48 hours of college credit and an associate's in interdisciplinary studies. He is a member of the National Honor Society. He is a Tech Prep scholar. He is a Texas scholar, an early college high school graduate, and plans on attending Wabash College and major in economics and minor in business. Anthony Kane Garcia is the son of Kane Garcia and Gladys Garcia. Kane has earned 30 hours of college credit and is a Texas scholar. He plans on attending the University of Texas Rio Grande Valley, major in biomedical science and minor in business. Jose Angel Garza Jr. is the son of Sandra Yvette Garza and Jose Garza. He has earned 15 hours of college credit, is a Texas scholar, and an early college high school graduate. He plans on attending the University of Texas Rio Grande Valley, major in psychology, and minor in sociology. Luis Jonathan Garza is the son of Luis Jonathan Garza and has earned 33 hours of college credit. He is a Texas scholar and a University of Texas Rio Grande Valley future student. He will major in kinesiology and minor in biology. Angelica Raquel Godinez is the daughter of Gloria Godinez and Ezequiel Godinez. She has earned 22 hours of college credit, a certification as a multimedia specialist, and is a dual language graduate, a Texas scholar, and an early college high school graduate. She plans on attending the University of Texas, Texas A&M International, major in criminology and minor in psychology. Manuel Gonzalez IV is the son of Manuel Gonzalez III and Ada X. Gonzalez. He has earned 20 hours of college credit, is a Tech Prep Scholar and a Texas Scholar, and will be attending Texas Tech University and major in animal science with a science option. Marco Amadeo Gonzalez is the son of Jose Amadeo Gonzalez and Ilsa Trevino Gonzalez. He has earned 17 hours of college credit and is a Texas Scholar and will be attending the University of Texas Rio Grande Valley and major in communication and minor in physical education. Ronaldo Gonzalez is the son of Imelda and Aldo Gonzalez. He has earned 47 hours of college credit, is a Texas Scholar and an early college high school graduate. He will be attending the University of Texas Rio Grande Valley, major in economics and minor in biology. Oksana Lizette Guerrero is a daughter of Miguel Guerrero Jr. and Elaine Moreno. She has earned 21 hours of college credit, is a dual language graduate, a Texas Scholar, and an early college high school graduate. She is enlisting in the United States Air Force Academy. Melissa Guadalupe Hernandez Ramirez is a daughter of Hector Moises Hernandez and Maria Hernandez. She has earned 48 hours of college credit, is a National Honor Society member, a Texas Scholar, and an early college high school graduate. She will be attending the University of Texas Rio Grande Valley and major in nursing. Ramiro Hernandez Jr. is the son of Juanita and Ramiro Hernandez. He has earned 60 hours of college credit and an associate's in interdisciplinary studies. He is a Texas Scholar and an early college high school graduate. He plans on attending the University of Texas Rio Grande Valley and major in as an electrical engineer. Tamara Sarai Hernandez is a daughter of Gamaleli and Esther Hernandez. She has earned 60 hours of college credit and a certification as a substitute for teaching. She has also earned an associate's in criminal justice. She is a Texas Scholar and an early college high school graduate. She will be attending the University of Texas Rio Grande Valley and major in criminology and minor in biology. Jose Francisco Hinojosa is the son of Ana Luisa Rubacalba. He has earned 60 hours of college credit and an associate's in interdisciplinary studies. He is also a National Honor Society member, a Texas Scholar, and an early college high school graduate. He plans on attending the University of Texas at Austin, major in psychology and minor in sociology. Vanessa Iracheta is the daughter of Maria Cristina Yuloyo and Pedro Luis Iracheta. She has earned 46 hours of college credit and a certification as a multimedia specialist and is a National Honor Society member, a Texas Scholar, and an early college high school graduate. She plans on attending the University of Texas Rio Grande Valley and major in kinesiology. Susan Orchid Jaramillo is a daughter of Carla Diaz and has earned 35 hours of college credit. She is a Texas Scholar and an early college high school graduate. She plans on attending the University of Texas Rio Grande Valley and major in physical therapy. Brianna Eileen Leal is a daughter of Jessica Yadira Leal and Ricardo Leal. She has earned 63 hours of college credit and an associate's in secondary education. She is a National Honor Society member, a Texas Scholar, and an early college high school graduate. She plans on attending the University of Texas at Austin and major in psychology. Isai Llanos is the son of Erica Llanos and Orlando Castañeda. He has earned 47 hours of college credit, is a member of the National Honor Society, a Tech Prep Scholar, a Texas Scholar, and an early college high school graduate. He will be attending the University of Texas Rio Grande Valley, major in education, and minor in childhood growth and development. Tabitha Lopez is a daughter of Javier Lopez and Maribel Cantu. She has earned 41 hours of college credit, is a National Honor Society member, a Texas Scholar, and an early college high school graduate. She will be attending the University of Texas San Antonio, major in biomedical sciences and minor in biology. Edgar Isaac Lozano is the son of Maria Lozano and Juan Lozano. He has earned 34 hours of college credit, is a Texas Scholar, and an early college high school graduate. He will be attending the University of Texas Rio Grande Valley and major in criminal justice and minor in finance. Brittany Diana Lucio is a daughter of Roxanne Garcia and Aurelio Lucio. She has earned 62 hours of college credit and an associate's in interdisciplinary studies. She is a Texas Scholar and an early college high school graduate. She will be attending the University of Texas at Austin and major in exploratory studies. Anaïs Magallanes is a daughter of Salvador Magallanes and Karina Salas. She has earned 36 hours of college credit. She is a Texas Scholar and an early college high school graduate. She will be attending the University of Texas Rio Grande Valley. Lisbeth Maldonado is a daughter of Joel and Irene Maldonado, has earned 13 hours of college credit. She is a Texas Scholar and plans on attending the University of Texas Rio Grande Valley. Alexia Ann Mares is the daughter of Glenda Lee Morgan and Alexander Oscar Mares. She has earned 74 college credit hours and an associate's in nursing. She is a National Honor Society member. She is a Texas Scholar and an early college high school graduate. She will be attending Texas A&M University and major in biomedical sciences and minor in psychology. Brianna Alexis Mares is a daughter of ID Mares and Quentin Anthony Mares. She has earned 59 college credit hours and a certification in substitute teaching and an associate's in interdisciplinary studies. She is an early college high school graduate. She is a Texas Scholar and will be attending the University of Texas Rio Grande Valley, major in psychology and minor in criminal justice. Guadalupe Martin Resendiz is the daughter of Maria Resendiz and Timoteo Olvera. She has earned 12 college credit hours and is a Texas Scholar, an early college high school graduate, and will be attending the University of Texas San Antonio and major in biology. Stephanie Martinez is a daughter of Alberto and Guadalupe Martinez, has earned 60 hours of college credit. She is a member of the National Honor Society. She is a Texas Scholar and an early college high school graduate. She will be attending the University of Texas Rio Grande Valley, major in exercise science and minor in psychology. Laura Martinez Jimenez is a daughter of Cecilia Jimenez and Jose Luis Martinez. She has earned 60 hours of college credit, is a Texas scholar, an early college high school graduate, and will be attending the University of Texas Rio Grande Valley and major in education and minor in English as a secondary language. Alisa Marie Mendoza is a daughter of Estela Marie Mendoza and Arnoldo Mendoza. She has earned 46 hours of college credit, is a Texas scholar, and an early college high school graduate. Deborah Anel Mendoza is a daughter of Sylvia Aurora Mendoza and Jose Anonio Mendoza. She has earned 60 hours of college credit and an associate's in interdisciplinary studies. She is a member of the National Honor Society, a Texas scholar, and an early college high school graduate. She will be attending the University of Texas Rio Grande Valley, major in biology and minor in chemistry. Guadalupe Lisbeth Mendoza is a daughter of Patricia Lopez. Guadalupe has earned 70 hours of college credit, an associate's in nursing, and is a Texas scholar and an early college high school graduate. She plans on attending the University of Texas Rio Grande Valley and major in nursing. Carelis Gabriela Mesquitic is a daughter of Belinda Mesquitic and Ezequiel Mesquitic. She has earned 33 hours of college credit, is an early college high school graduate, a Texas scholar, and will be attending the University of Texas Rio Grande Valley, major in nursing and minor in business. Maria Fernanda Monjar Maldonado is a daughter of Monjares Maricela and Cruz Cortez Jr. She has earned 43 hours of college credit and a certification as a multimedia specialist. She is a dual language graduate, a Texas scholar, and an early college high school graduate. She will be attending the University of Texas Rio Grande Valley, major in elementary education, and as a bilingual generalist. Paola Rosie Munoz is a daughter of Heriberto and Antoineta Munoz. She has earned 30 hours of college credit and a certification as a teacher aide certified and is also a certified substitute teacher. She is a Texas scholar and an early college high school graduate. She will be attending the University of Texas Rio Grande Valley and major in interdisciplinary studies and minor in English. Sharon Ortiz is a daughter of Eduardo and Georgina Ortiz. She has earned 33 hours of college credit and is a multimedia specialist. She is a Texas scholar and will be attending South Texas College and major in nursing. Maritza Jacqueline Oyarvides is a daughter of Maria Guadalupe Mancias. She has earned 60 hours of college credit and an associate's in interdisciplinary studies. She is a Texas scholar and an early college high school graduate and will be attending the University of Texas Rio Grande Valley and major in business management and minor in finance. Taylor Renee Osuna is a daughter of Shannon Stacy Davis and Pedro Osuna. She has earned 60 hours of college credit and an associate's degree in interdisciplinary studies. She is a Texas scholar and an early college high school graduate. She will be attending the University of Texas Rio Grande Valley and major in social work. Itati Anicet Perez is a daughter of Daisy Perez and Benjamin Perez. Itati has earned 80 hours of college credit and an associate's in nursing. She is a National Honor Society member, a Texas scholar, and an early college high school graduate. She will be attending the University of Texas Arlington and pursue a doctorate in nursing. Jonathan Martinez Perez is a son of Guillermo Perez and has earned 57 hours of college credit and is a Texas scholar. He will be attending the University of Houston and major in business marketing and psychology. Victor Hugo Perez is the son of Victor Hugo Perez and Maria Paula Perez. He's received 62 hours of college credit and an associate's in interdisciplinary studies. He is a Texas scholar and an early college high school graduate. He will be attending the University of Texas Rio Grande Valley and major in clinical laboratory sciences. Jose Puente Olvera is the son of Lorena de Jesus Puente and Abel Puente. He is a Texas scholar and an early college high school graduate. He will be attending the University of Texas Rio Grande Valley, major in mechanical engineering and minor in psychology. Erica Cristina Ramirez is a daughter of Fabiola Ramirez and has earned 63 hours of college credit. She is a Texas scholar and an early college high school graduate. She will be attending the University of Texas Rio Grande Valley and major in criminal justice and minor in business. Ariana Rivera is a daughter of Jaime Rivera and has earned 43 hours of college credit. She is a Texas scholar and an early college high school graduate and plans on attending the University of Texas Rio Grande Valley. Luis Alberto Rivera is the son of Flor Estela Melendez and has earned 36 hours of college credit. He is a Texas scholar and an early college high school graduate. He plans on attending the University of Indianapolis and major in music technology and recording. Cassandra Itzel Rodriguez is a daughter of Griselda Veronica Rodriguez and Romeo Rodriguez. She has 70 hours of college credit and has received an associate's in interdisciplinary studies. She is a member of the National Honor Society, a Tech Prep scholar, a Texas scholar, and an early college high school graduate. She will be attending the University of Texas at Austin and major in supply chain management and minor in logistics. Leslie Lupita Rodriguez is a daughter of Irma Rodriguez and Javier Alberto Rodriguez. She has earned 33 hours of college credit, is a Texas scholar, an early college high school graduate, and will be attending Texas Women's University, where she will study dance and minor in business. Austin Nathaniel Science is the son of Annabel Science and James Michael Science. He has earned 44 hours of college credit, is a Texas scholar, and an early college high school graduate. He will be attending Texas A&M Kingsville. Felix Cruz Salinas is the son of Raquel Espinosa
and has earned 60 hours of college credit and an associate's in interdisciplinary studies. He earned it with a distinction of magna cum laude. He is a Texas scholar, an early college high school graduate, and will be attending Texas State Technical College and major in network and security and minor in computer sciences. Guadalupe Salinas is a daughter of Guadalupe Salinas and Olga Salinas. She has a total of 80 college credit hours and is receiving an associate's in nursing. She has earned her degree with cum laude distinction. She is a member of the National Honor Society, a Texas scholar, and an early college high school graduate. She will be attending the University of Texas Rio Grande Valley and major in nursing and minor in biology. Karina Lizeth Salinas is a daughter of Rogelio Salinas and Carmen Salinas. She has received her associate's in interdisciplinary studies. She is a National Honor Society member. She is a Texas scholar and an early college high school graduate. She plans to attend the University of Texas Rio Grande Valley, major in psychology and minor in education. Serena Alicia Salinas is a daughter of Erica and Michael Salinas. She has earned 60 hours of college credit and an associate's in interdisciplinary studies. She is a National Honor Society member. She is a Texas scholar and an early college high school graduate. She will attend the University of Texas Rio Grande Valley and major in psychology. Victoria Andrea Salinas is a daughter of Lilia Denise Salinas, has earned 41 college credit hours. She is a member of the National Honor Society, a Tech Prep scholar, a Texas scholar, and an early college high school graduate. She plans on attending Texas A&M University, major in biomedical sciences and minor in business. Alisa Celeste Sandoval is a daughter of Jaime Samuel Sandoval and Linda Sandoval. She has earned 60 hours of college credit and an associate's in interdisciplinary studies. She is a member of the National Honor Society. She is a Texas scholar and an early college high school graduate. She plans on attending the University of Texas at Austin and major in radio, television, and film. Rachel Segundo is in absentia. Sebastian Tijerina is a son of Sergio Tijerina and Maribel Tijerina. He has earned 58 hours of college credit and an associate's in interdisciplinary studies. He is a National Honor Society member, a Tech Prep scholar, a Texas scholar, and an early college high school graduate. He will be attending the University of Texas Rio Grande Valley and major in civil engineering. Alejandro Omar Treviño Jr. is the son of Alejandro Omar Treviño and Blanca Aguino. He has earned 34 hours of college credit, is a Texas scholar, and an early college high school graduate. He plans on attending the University of Texas Rio Grande Valley and major in kinesiology. Liza Monique Treviño is a daughter of Liza Quintanilla Treviño and Monico Treviño. She has earned 61 hours of college credit and an associate's in interdisciplinary studies. She is a National Honor Society member, a Texas scholar, and an early college high school graduate. She will be attending the University of Texas Rio Grande Valley and major in education. Yasmin Araceli Valenzuela is a daughter of Javier and Zenaida Valenzuela. She has earned 31 hours of college credit. She is a Texas scholar and an early college high school graduate. She will be attending the University of Texas Rio Grande Valley and major in nursing and minor in psychology. Lizeth Vega Cepeda is a daughter of Juana Vega and Rodolfo Vega. She has earned 12 hours of college credit. She is a dual language graduate, a Texas scholar, and an early college high school graduate. She will be attending South Texas College and major in elementary teaching. Alejandra Alicia Vela is a daughter of Fernando Vela and Rocio Alba Prodis. She has earned 61 hours of college credit and an associate's degree in interdisciplinary studies. She is a member of the National Honor Society, a Texas scholar, and an early college high school graduate. She will be attending the University of Texas at Austin and major in government and minor in political science. Juan Jose Vela is the son of Sandra Noyola Vela and Juan Jose Vela. He has earned 30 hours of college credit and is a Texas scholar and an early college high school graduate. He will be attending the University of Texas Rio Grande Valley, major in computer science and minor in psychology. Ana Leah Vigil is a daughter of Olga and Ramiro Vigil. She has earned 18 hours of college credit, is a Texas scholar, an early college high school graduate, and will be attending the University of Texas Rio Grande Valley, major in business management and minor in entrepreneurship. Abigail Villarreal is a daughter of Monica Villarreal. She has earned 75 college credit hours and her associate's degree in nursing. She earned that distinction with cum laude distinction. She is a National Honor Society member, a Texas scholar, and an early college high school graduate. She plans on attending the University of Texas Rio Grande Valley, major in nursing and minor in biology. Jesus Eduardo Yanez is the son of Lorenzo Javier Yanez and Maria Carmen Yanez. He has earned 12 hours of college credit, is a Texas scholar, an early college high school graduate, and will be attending the University of Texas Rio Grande Valley, major in English and minor in communication. Ladies and gentlemen, presenting our salutatorian, Iris Annette Garcia. Iris Annette Garcia is a salutatorian for the class of 2017 with an overall average of 115.2. She is a daughter of Elizabeth Garcia. Iris has excelled both inside and outside of school, and is part of two honor societies for recognition of her academic efforts. She is a member of the National Honor Society and the Phi Data Kappa International Honor Society. She is also a member of Student Council and UIL, where she has earned recognition in the areas of science and journalism. Iris has earned 106 hours from South Texas College and is graduating with an associate's degree in nursing. She is one of the 8 PSJA ISD high school students who will graduate in the nation's first, that is the nation's first dual enrollment program for nursing. After high school, Iris plans to attend the University of Texas at Austin, where she will major in biochemistry. The University of Texas at Austin also accepted her into the Freshman Research Initiative for the College of Natural Sciences. Iris's goal is to receive a master's degree in biochemistry with research in pharmacognetics and attend medical school to become a pediatric geneticist. Ladies and gentlemen, graduating with a GPA of 115.2 is your salutatorian, Iris Annette Garcia. And now, presenting to you PSJA Memorial Early College High School's Class of 2017 valedictorian, Mr. Orlando Ochoa Jr. Orlando Ochoa Jr. is a valedictorian for the class of 2017 with a GPA of 118.1. He is the eldest son of Gloria Evangelina Moreno. Orlando completed an associate's degree of arts in sociology with honors, summa cum laude, from South Texas College in December of 2016. Orlando's hard work, noteworthy honors include South Texas College President's Honor Roll. He was recognized by the Monitor and the FAR Rotary Club as Student of the Week. He is Texas Music Educators Association All-State Symphonic Band member. He is a 3-time TMEA All-Region Band member, 2-time TMEA All-Region Orchestra member, and 3-time Texas State Solo and Ensemble medalist, and was selected as a National Dell Scholar. Orlando actively participated in numerous student organizations, including the Go Team, Full Orchestra, and Jazz Band. He has held the following leadership positions. As a freshman, he was captain of the cheerleading squad. He was a Mighty Green Machine Band percussion captain, vice president, and head drum major. He is your student council secretary, and he is an early college student ambassador. In recognition of his outstanding academic achievements, he is also a member of the National Honor Society, the Chi Epsilon Chapter of Sigma Kappa Delta, Society of Honors Sociology Alpha Delta. Orlando will be attending the University of Texas at Austin, double major in International Relations and Global Studies and Sociology. After completion of his undergraduate studies, he plans to pursue a law degree and dedicate his time to advocacy, human rights work, and scholarship in the Rio Grande Valley. Ladies and gentlemen, graduating with a GPA of 118.1 is your valedictorian, Orlando Ochoa Jr. At this time, I'd like to welcome our second ever Emerald Queen 2017, Mrs. Gidalti Cárdenas.
I would like to thank everyone once again for being here for us and with us, and for just, you know, parents, teachers, staff, everybody, board members, for being with us throughout this journey. And if you would allow me, I would like to pray over us. So please bow our heads. Let's pray. Dear Heavenly Father, thank you for this day. Thank you for this gathering. Thank you for allowing us to be here tonight, Lord. I pray that you are with each and every one of us, Lord, in our endeavors, in our future, wherever we have chosen to go, Lord, wherever you have led us. I pray that you guide us and that you give us the wisdom and the discernment to just honor you and do everything we can to the best of our ability. I pray that you are with us, that you help us, Lord, and that we make our parents proud, we make our family proud, and we make this district that we are part of and that you have allowed us to be a part of very, very proud, Lord. Thank you for all that you have done for us, for all that you will do. And as your word says, Lord, in Jeremiah 29:11, you know the plans that you have for us, Lord. May we keep that in our hearts, and may we just continue to worship you and know that you will be with us and that you will take us to where we are meant to be in our future. In your name we pray, amen.
Thank you, Giraldi. Ladies and gentlemen, this concludes our Distinguished Achievement Program Banquet for 2017. Everyone have a nice evening, and thank you for joining us today.